anarchy inspired by the breakdown of society after the Russian Revolution and in the aftermath of World War I. The first image evokes panic and confusion because the falcon becomes lost, just as humanity's sense of morality seemed lost after the World War. Turning and turning in the widening gyre, the falcon cannot hear the falconer. Things fall apart. The center cannot hold. Mere anarchy is loosed upon the world. The blood-dimmed tide is loosed, and everywhere the ceremony of innocence is drowned. The best lack all conviction, while the worst are full of passionate intensity. Surely some revelation is at hand. Surely the second coming is at hand. The second coming. Hardly are those words out when a vast image out of Spiritus Mundi troubles my sight. Somewhere in sands of the desert, a shape with lion body and the head of a man, a gaze blank and pitiless as the sun, is moving its slow thighs, while all about it reel shadows of the indignant desert birds. The darkness drops again. But now I know that 20 centuries of stony sleep were vexed to nightmare by a rocking cradle. And what rough beast, its hour come at last, slouches toward Bethlehem to be born. It's my privilege now to introduce Jackie Cabasso, who is executive director of Western States Legal Foundation and my friend. And I don't have to say anything else about her. I think all of you know her and love her almost as much as I do.
All right, so I am actually the pinch hitter for the call to action because our heroic porta potty transport person, Sherry Beville, was supposed to do the call to action, but she is engaged in service to us. So let's have a round of applause for Sherry. Okay, so Dan asked you this earlier, but how many of you have been here once before? How many of you have been here more than five times before? Okay, how many of you have been here 20 times? How many of you have been here 37 times? Okay, so I think on behalf of all of us, it is my honor to accept the Lifetime Achievement Award that was bestowed on us by Dan Ellsberg. So let's hear it for us. Okay, so I think that poem that Phyllis read really captures the moment, and so I also want to thank you for being able to get out of bed and come here, despite how awful everything seems right now. We have to be here. We have no choice. But I do want to share a little good news. We have few victories. Here's one that I like to make you aware of. The U.S. Conference of Mayors, which is the national nonpartisan association of mayors with cities with populations over 30,000, there are about 1,400 of those cities, unanimously adopted a Mayors for Peace resolution on July 1st, calling on all presidential candidates to make known their positions on nuclear weapons and to pledge U.S. global leadership in preventing nuclear war, returning to diplomacy, and negotiating the elimination of nuclear weapons. So I want you to know that, and I want you to bombard the media and bombard the candidates and use this to say the mayors of America's big cities want you to talk about how you're going to get rid of nuclear weapons as part of the presidential campaign. So, as we prepare to walk to the West Gate of the Livermore Lab, this is what Sherry was going to share with you. The current situation of the Kings Bay Plowshare 7 defendants who will be going to a pretrial hearing in federal court tomorrow in Georgia. The trial is expected to be set for this fall. These seven activists say that necessity is what drove them to break into a naval submarine base in April 2018 to protest the existence of nuclear weapons. They believe, as I do, and many of you, that the prospect of nuclear war and potential for annihilating humanity is only a hair trigger away. Three of the seven defendants have chosen to remain in detention these last 15 months rather than agree to pay $50,000 in bail and wearing an ankle monitor. They all face the possibility of up to 25 years in prison. A strong show of support will take place at Kings Bay Naval Base August 6th through 9th, including events of fast and vigils. And there is a table over there with more information. Check it out. So, keeping those folks in mind, please take a few moments to... Excuse me. Sorry, important interruption. I've been asked to point out to you that the porta potties have been relocated close to us here. So, okay. So, in gratitude for the in gratitude to the Kings Bay Plowshare 7 and the movement of the porta potties, I want to ask you to take a few minutes to reflect on why you are here today. And I know why I'm here today, and I think you know why you're here today, but take a moment. So in just a few minutes, we're going to process to the west gate of the lab. Upon arrival, we will participate in a traditional Japanese bond dance to call in the ancestors, including the victims of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and that will be led by Chizu Hamada. Following the dance, sirens will sound in remembrance of the victims of the atomic bombs dropped by the United States on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Those sirens will signal a die-in. Those who choose may lie down and be outlined in chalk in the gate area. Some may choose to get up and leave their outline. Others may stay in position and risk arrest. Some people may choose to risk arrest by standing in the gate area in front of the prone bodies and the outlines. Those who choose not to risk arrest will stand aside and bear witness. The chalk outlines we will briefly leave behind today are a solemn reminder of the shadows of human beings vaporized by atomic bombs 74 years ago that still haunt the walls and sidewalks of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. If you are planning to risk arrest, we invite you to put your name on a sign-up sheet, which is at the table down there. Mary Lee is waving her hands. There's also legal information for people considering risking arrest. And finally, in a last-minute development, which we're very happy about, Yoko Kaneko, Julie Hernandez, and Louise Dunlap will lead us with drumming and chanting at the beginning of our march. And they'll be drumming in solidarity with the Buddhist nuns and monks of Nipponzen Myohogi. So I would invite everyone now to catch your breath, get some water if you need it. There's water at the table here. And visit the tables, visit the porta potty, and begin processing to the gate of the lab down that way. Thank you all for being here.